Before we start the video, let me give you a brief introduction about myself. I'm Chandresh Mahajan, who is founder and chief educator at Exergic, which is India's most trusted and comprehensive institute for online GATE preparation. I got an All India rank 37 from GATE Mechanical Engineering, and I am an ex-Indian Oil officer, having 6+ years of teaching experience as of now. To know more about our GATE courses, you can contact us on these details. Also, you can download Exergic GATE preparation app from Google Play Store. The link is available in the description of video. So as I explained you, to solve the question of plane trusses, method of section is a better and smarter and faster way rather than using method of joints. And as I told you, it is my personal method of solving the questions of plane trusses. Let me give you an example to prove it, that how method of joint can be painful, lengthy, and even not very much possible way to solve the questions, but method of section will solve it just in 2 steps. Have a look at the question. It says that the plane truss shown has hinged supports at P and W. You can see that there is a plane truss, and at P and W it is having hinged supports, and it is subjected to horizontal forces as shown. 3 horizontal forces you can see are acting at Q, R and S. The magnitude of force in member XW is how much kilonewton? XW, this member. Tell the magnitude of force in the XW member. Now, as I told you that almost many aspirants, you know, consider method of joint to be easy, because there they don't have to use their brain, their innovation at all. They just have to start from one point and keep solving equations. So obviously that is comfortable and easier to start, right? But that may not give you the answer, as I told you, in less time, or maybe it may not be able to solve the question at all. In this case, XW is the member where you need to find out the force. Obviously, you cannot apply the method of joint at X, because there are 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 unknown members cannot be done, right? I have already told you that how many unknown members should be there. Come to point W. At W also, 1, 2, 3 unknowns are already there, and then there is a hinge which will be having unknown reactions. So at W also it does not make sense. I have already told you this, that whenever trying to solve and pick a point for method of joint, don't select these joints where you have unknown forces, because you have to first calculate the unknown forces and only then you can proceed with those, right? So what are the points where the forces are known? Those will be the most convenient way always to solve the question of method of joint, right? That is point Q, R and S. Now what your logic says? Your logic says that we have to reach at this point X, right? And we have to use method of joint. So we have to move joint by joint, right? So let's start from point Q, which is closest. But when you analyze the point Q, you can very clearly see that there are 1, 2, 3 and 4 unknown forces. You cannot apply the method of joint here, because the number of unknowns here are 4. What equations you can apply? Summation fx0, summation fy0 at any joint. You know that moment equation cannot be applied at any joint. So 2 equations, 4 unknowns cannot be solved. Same is the story at point R. R and Q, structure wise they look same, right? Only point is the S, from where you can start. At point S, 2 unknowns are there. This SV is the first, SR is the second. SR is a zero force member, right? Because on the vertical side, on the other side, there is no link connected to any angle, right? So SR is a zero force member. Force in VS will be 10 kilonewton directly. So by analyzing this, you got the force in SR. Now you may think that now let us move to point R now. Right? So this is the free body diagram of point R. Now, whatever discussion I am going to continue, that may seem overloaded to you because I am trying to reject the method of joint here, right? So I am not going to solve it using method of joint because I know that it is a very bad choice for this question. So just try to go with what I am telling you without actually trying to solve it. It will only waste your time. Okay. In this case of point R, FRV, FRU and FRQ are three unknowns. We have only two equations, summation FX, summation FY, zero. Obviously, you cannot find out all three. But maybe FRV you can find out. How? Because at point V, at this point V, this force is known, right? VZ, how much should be VZ? Tell me, how much should be VZ? At point Z, there is no force acting. You draw free body diagram of point Z, joint Z, one force horizontal, other force vertical. No other external force. Both of them have to be zero. So, from there you can find out that Vz is 0, Vs you already know. So, only two unknowns are there, Vr and Vy. Okay. So, you from there you can find out Vr, right? Till now we have analyzed 1, 2, 3 and this is the fourth joint we are analyzing, right? So, Rv you calculated from there. You came to point R. From there, Ru and Rq you found out. This value also, this value also. Now you came at point Q. At point Q also, this RQ is known, but this is unknown, this is unknown, this is unknown. Again, you have to analyze QU in some way so that you can find out these two unknown. To analyze U, you need to analyze Y. Look at the question. Just look at the question where it is going. We have to solve each and every joint in order to find out right now to analyze point Q here, right? In the same manner you have to analyze throughout. Maybe you will think that I will directly analyze X, from Y I will move to X, but for X you need TX, for TX you need T, for T you need QT. So parallelly you have to solve all these joints in order to reach at joint X, and there is no such guarantee that every such data will be given to you in the question to solve it. That is why method of joint is a very poor choice for this case. You not only have to analyze lot of joints, you also have to analyze lot of equations, and question can be twisted in a way that method of joint will not give you the right answer, will not even reach you to the answer. That is why if you are able to reach at the answer in two or maybe three joints, then it is perfect. You can follow method of joint. But as I have told you that if you want to reach at the answer in one step, method of section is the way. Obviously, it requires practice. What section to select, it is totally up to you. And that is where your concept, your innovation thinking comes into action. Right, because there is no fixed way to do it, and that is where you can check yourself as an engineer that how much innovative thinking you have to solve any problem at hand. In this case, if I reject the method of joint, which I should reject, and if I tell you that follow the method of section, and now tell me which section should I choose, what will you say? That sir, XW has to be selected, right? I have told you this already. And in obviously in method of section, the section which is unknown, the member where force is unknown, where you want to find out the force, that has to be selected. So XW has to be selected. So section should obviously include XW, right or not? Now tell me, how should I proceed this section? Should I cut it like this or like this? Remember one more tip that I gave you in previous lectures, that preferably try to exclude the unknown reactions from the section and try to include as many known forces are given to you in the question. So it will not be wise to section it like this. Because if section it like this, then this unknown force P will come into my section. This is going to be the section that I will use, because known forces are present in this section. So P will be an unknown force. I don't want to calculate unknown force, right? So I will not only exclude W, but I will also exclude P from the section. So maybe I am not finalizing the section yet. Maybe I will cut it like this. Then P and W are gone out, and only this part is the selected section. Now in this part, if I just roughly show you that how this section's FBD, lower part FBD, is going to look, then this is how it is going to look. This is point Q, this is T, this is X. This is force XW. This is force TW, right? Force TW. This is force TP. And this is force QP, right? Now here, recall again what tip I gave you. I told you that when you take a section, if you have taken the perfect section, you just need to find out one moment. Take any moment and your answer will be in front of you. If you have chosen the perfect section, method of section is a one step way to solve question, right? In this case, we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 unknown forces, right? If I want to take the moment about any point, what will be that point? What should be that point? Recall again what I taught you. I told you that take a moment about such a point where unknown forces cancel out, they become zero, right? For example, if in this section that I have made, upper part I have not shown here, only this lower part I am showing. If in this lower part, I take moment about P, right? So QP and TP will become zero. Now don't confuse that, sir, how can we take moment about P? P is not in the section. But that is what I have taught you, that we can take the moment about any point which is not in our section, right? This point P is not present in the section, but still I can take moment about any point outside of my section as well. So if I take moment about point P, I know that these two forces will coincide and meet there, right? So these two forces will become zero in this section, whole section. I will take moment about P. In reality, P is not in the section. P is not available into the section. But the forces of the section, when you extend them, they meet at point P. So I can take the moment about point P. Right or not? I have told you this already. So if I take the moment about point P in this section, QP and TP, these two forces will become zero. Their moment will become zero, right? But moment of TW and XW will become non-zero, because these two are not meeting at point P. They will have some moment about point P. But again, you have two unknowns, TW and XW. Just by using a single equation of moment about P, you cannot find out both of them, right? So maybe you will try to use summation FX0, summation FY0, but you will not be able to find out the answer using this section. Because ultimately four unknown forces are there. If you apply the equilibrium equation for this whole section, you can use only three equations: summation fx, summation fy, summation of moment. But four unknowns are there, right? So you cannot solve this if you apply the concept of equilibrium for the section, right? You have to apply the tip, the funda that I gave you. What funda? The funda of moment. Take the moment about some point where unknown forces are automatically becoming zero. Maybe there are 10 unknowns, but if 9 unknowns are meeting at a common point, right? That point may not be in the section, but take the moment about that point. 9 will become zero. The moment of 9 unknowns will become zero. Only one unknown will be left. Write down the equation and solve it. So in this case, please think, what is that point? Means how can we take a section where unknown forces are in such a way that maximum of them are coinciding at a point? Think of it. In this case, this section, as I told you, is not going to get you the answer easily. So what should I do? Obviously, XW I have to include in this section. And don't think that, sir, this much thinking, how will we do in the exam, right? As a beginner, you may feel that it's a difficult question and selecting the section is difficult. Going by the method of join is also difficult. But once you start practicing the questions of method of section, you will find it very interesting and easy to select the sections, right? So in this manner, I cannot go. I cannot go like this. I cannot go like this. Can I go like this? Can I just make a section like this? Seems innovative, right? Because we have a habit of selecting a section in a straight line. We think that section has to be a straight line. It's not necessary. You can select any shape of the section. And what is the benefit of selecting this section? The benefit of selecting this section is that look at the unknown forces. What are the unknown forces in this section, this whole section? This is going to be an unknown force. This is going to be an unknown force, right? Because this part is removed from the section. So this part and this part is present in the section. This lower part, T is not in the section, P is not in the section, W is not in the section. So in this section, unknown will be this one, which we need to calculate, and this one. So four unknown forces will be left if I select this section, right? This was point T. So let me write this force as F, Q, T. This is F, Q, P. This is F, X, T. And this is F, X, W, which is required. Now look at the unknown forces here. 1, 2, 3, 4 are unknown, right? But F, Q, T, F, X, T and F, Q, P. All of them are meeting at this point Q, right or not? This is also passing from Q. Obviously, both of them are passing from Q. Other than XW, all three of them are passing through Q. If in this section, I take the moment about Q and equate it to zero, equilibrium equation, then automatically FQP's moment will become zero. It is passing through Q. FQT moment will become zero. FXT moment will become zero. Right or not? This 10 kilonewton moment will also become zero. Right? So only two forces you have now, no unknown reactions are present, and you have 10 kilonewton at S, 10 kilonewton at R. Those two will have their moment and unknown XW. Other than that, 1, 2, 3 and 4, these four forces, out of those four, one is known, three are unknown. All of their moment will become zero, right? 10 kilonewton clockwise moment, 10 kilonewton clockwise moment. This is also having clockwise moment, at least in the diagram. But obviously, for equilibrium, it has to go counterclockwise, right? We will come at the direction after solving the question. So right now, let us take moment about point Q. So 10 kilonewton multiplied by this distance, which is 4 plus 4, right? 4 plus 4, which is 8. Plus this 10 kilonewton multiplied by this distance, which is 4. Plus this FXW multiplied by this distance, which is also 2 plus 2, 4. So unknown FXW multiplied by 4 should be equal to 0. And when you solve it, 120, you will get FXW as minus 30 kilonewton. Means we have assumed the tensile force to act in FXW, but in reality, sign is negative, means force acting in XW is 30 kilonewton and it is compressive. Question is only asking you the magnitude. So please don't do the mistake of writing minus 30 as the answer. Answer is going to be only 30 kilonewton. So look at this question. Using method of joint, it was going to be very lengthy, and suppose question made even more blocks like this. Only one and two block is shown, right? I can make five such blocks. Assume that this is the case. This is X, this is W. From here you have to start. and reach here. Solve it using method of joint. It will take you 15, 20 minutes, maybe half an hour. Still, you will not be able to reach at the right answer. Right or not? So, method of section, you have to be comfortable with it. Consider it as your friend, as your tool. Don't be scared of it. Because I see aspirants, generally, they prefer method of joint. Very common reason that we already know what to do. I have already given you 4-5 tips on selecting the joints that from where you should start. And those will fit for every question. You will be able to know the best joint to start from, right? But starting and reaching the answer, these two things are different. There, method of section will prove useful in almost every case. So whatever tips I have given you in earlier lectures regarding method of section, please be comfortable with them. Not only know them, but also apply them. And the method of section can have the section which is not a straight line. Like in this case, any shape you can select. You can select it like this also, whatever sections you want to cut, whatever members you want to cut, you can cut them. They don't have to fall in the straight line. That gives you even more, that makes this method of section even more powerful, right? So whatever tips I have given you earlier and whatever you learn from this example, it will definitely help you in become friendly with method of section even more.